Well, we've developed a COVID-19 misinformation tracking center where we, when we started out, when we launched it about 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, we had about 80 or 90 sites that we had discovered. There are now, I think, 176 sites. And what we've done on a pro bono basis is offer that list of these hoax sites to any brand that wants it so that they can keep their ads off of those hoax sites. Again, with programmatic advertising, with the best ad agencies who brag about all their whitelists and, you know, all their brand safety efforts, their programmatic ads are always ending up on hoax sites. And in particular, they're ending up now on hoax sites related to COVID-19. So what we're doing is making it possible for them easily to stay off of those sites, and most important, to support legitimate news sites. If you put COVID-19 down as a blocking word, as we have found, your ads are going to be blocked by the brand safety companies from appearing on the homepage of the New York Times. That's insane. And that's because people have the illusion that artificial intelligence solves every problem. Our human intelligence can solve this problem, because the way we achieve scale is, instead of worrying about individual articles, we rate the overall reliability of the publisher. So that means we don't solve all the problems of the world. If you want to keep your ad off of an article about a plane crash and you're an airline, BrandGuard and NewsGuard won't solve that problem for you. But what we do offer is an additional layer of protection after you've used the artificial intelligence solutions to stay off of pornography and hate speech. You can use us to support legitimate news sites and stay away from the hoaxers.
I was wondering if you could share your thoughts about leadership and the media industry, about some best practices, about some advice perhaps to our colleagues in the industry.
Well, you know, that's hard for anyone. You know, it's easy to say, well, you know, don't think about the short term, think about the long term, everything's going to be fine. But it's hard to figure out how short the short term here is with this one, right? And I've been historically bad at cutting editorial expenses as opposed to using a business model where the better your editorial product, the more likely you are to attract, you know, paying subscribers and advertisers. And that, and it's easy for me to give that advice today because, you know, I'm not sitting on a payroll that might have 100 reporters, and, you know, you're not selling a single ad either online or in print. But I think the best advice that I've always thought of for editorial people and for publishers is that your editorial product really is your product. And where the journalism business has gone astray was when, in, you know, 10 years ago, everybody decided that it would be, that it would, or 15 years ago, that it would be really cool to have your stuff online and give it away for free because so many people would read it that you'd make all that money in ad revenue. Well, everybody's learned that lesson. And I think the lesson we learn over the long term from a crisis like this is that, you know, just the way a lot of people learn, you know, that government actually matters and government actually counts, by the same token, journalism about government and how it's performing really counts. And that needs to be supported. And the way to support that is, to the best extent possible, readers are to dip into their pockets at least a little bit and pay for that stuff.